We will solve the given system of equations using the method of elimination. The first step will be to clear the fractions from the equation by multiplying each equation by the least common denominator, which is the least common multiple of the denominators. But the first equation, we have 1/5 x minus 4/3 y equals 37/20. To clear the fractions from the equation, we'll multiply both sides by 20, which is the least common denominator, or the least common multiple of 5, 4, and 20. For the second equation, we have 4/3 x minus 1/5 y equals negative 31/15. The least common denominator is 15, which is the least common multiple of 3, 5, and 15. We will clear the fractions from the equation by multiplying both sides by 15. And now let's go ahead and show each product. For the first equation, we multiply both sides by 20, which indicates we have 20 times 1/5 x, or 20 divided by 1 times 1/5 x, minus 20 times 3/4 y, or minus 20 divided by 1 times 3/4 y, equals 20 times 37/20, or 20 divided by 1 times 37/20. Going to the second equation, we multiply both sides by 15, which gives us 15 times 4/3 x minus 15 times 1/5 y equals 15 times negative 31/15. And now let's simplify before multiplying. In the first equation, notice 20 and 5 share a common factor of 5. There is 1 5 and 5 and 4 5s and 20. We can just think of 20 divided by 5 is 4. For the second product, 20 and 4 share a common factor of 4. There is 1 4 and 4 and 5 4s and 20. Or 20 divided by 4 is 5. And for the last product on the right, 20 divided by 20 simplifies to 1. Or there's 1 20 and 20 in both cases. Now we'll multiply, which will give us an equivalent equation without fractions. For the first product, we have 4 times 1x, or 4x, minus, for the second product, we have 5 times 3y, or 15y, equals on the right, 1 times 37 is 37. Now for the second equation, again, we'll simplify before multiplying. And this is 4/3 x. 15 and 3 share a common factor of 3. There's 1 3 and 3 and 5 3s and 15, or 15 divided by 3 is 5. For the second product, 15 and 5 share a common factor of 5. There's 1 5 and 5 and 3 5s and 15, or 15 divided by 5 is 3. And for the last product, 15 divided by 15 simplifies to 1, or there's 1 15 and 15 in both cases. And now we multiply. For the first product, we have 5 times 4x, which is 20x. And we have minus 3 times 1y, or 3y, equals 1 times negative 31, which is negative 31. And now we'll take this equivalent system of equations and eliminate x or y using the elimination or addition method. We can eliminate either the x terms or y terms. I'm going to focus on the x terms. Notice if we multiply the first equation by negative 5, we would have negative 20x in the first equation, and we already have positive 20x in the second equation. The x terms will then be opposites. So let's take this approach. Let's multiply the first equation by negative 5, and we'll leave the second equation the same. Multiplying both sides of the first equation by negative 5, we have negative 5 times 4x, which is negative 20x. And then negative 5 times negative 15y simplifies to plus 75y equals, on the right side, to negative 5 times 37 is negative 185. The second equation remains the same. Now we add the two equations together. Notice negative 20x plus 20x is 0, which is why we multiplied the first equation by negative 5. 75y plus negative 3y is 72y, equals on the right side, negative 185 plus negative 31 is negative 216. Now we divide both sides by 72 to solve for y. Simplifying, we have y equals negative 216 divided by 72, which equals negative 3. Keeping track of our solution, which will be an ordered pair in the form of x comma y, we now know y equals negative 3. We need to perform back substitution to determine x. We can use any equation that has an x and a y in it to solve for x. Let's avoid the equations with fractions. Let's use this first equation here of 4x minus 15y equals 37 to solve for x. To do this, we substitute negative 3 for y and solve for x. So beginning with our equation, we substitute negative 3 for y, giving us 4x minus 15 times negative 3 equals 37. Simplifying, we have 4x plus 45 equals 37. Solving for x, we subtract 45 on both sides to isolate 4x. Simplifying, we now have 4x equals 37 minus 45, which is negative 8. Last step to solve for x, we divide both sides by 4. Simplifying, we have x equals negative 2, which indicates the solution is x equals negative 2 and y equals negative 3, which as an ordered pair is negative 2, comma, negative 3. Before we go, let's verify this graphically by graphing the original equations in Desmos and analyzing the graph to determine the point of intersection. I've already set this up in Desmos. Notice I've entered the equations here on the left. If we click on the point of intersection, we can see the solution is the ordered pair negative 2, comma, negative 3, verifying our work is correct. I hope you found this helpful.